Davis, a tremendous leader in the game of football, grew up fighting to keep himself from falling into the cycle of many of those he saw around him.
Well, I grew up in a small town called Sherman, Georgia. It's probably about 2.5 hours away from Atlanta. We have a population of about 900 to 1,000 people, and we are an area that's known for our poverty. Due to the fact that my mom was a single mom and we didn't have a whole lot, there were days where I had to go outside and, you know, actually run water from the fountain and actually put it on the stove, you know, to take a hot bath. Or there were days where we had to run an extension cord from the neighbor's house in order to just have lights in our house, you know. There were a lot of situations like that that really made me do the things that I'm doing today. And the reason I harp on the Christmas event and try to make it an event that is so big for the kids that we give back to is because I remember waking up Christmas morning a couple of times, maybe even 3 or 4 times, and finding out that Santa didn't come visit us, you know. And it was a situation that you couldn't understand why you start, because you still believing in Santa at the time, and you're thinking like, okay, what happened to me? Like, was I bad this year? Did I do the wrong things? And ultimately, as a kid, you start putting the things on yourself, and then you never think about, oh, my mom just couldn't afford to do it this year. She didn't have the money in order to make things happen for me or make things happen for my sister. And now that I'm older, I understand all that stuff, and I'm in a position where I can help other kids, and that's what I'm doing.
As of October 31st, 2010, Davis was placed on the reserve, physically unable to perform list, with an injured right knee. This bittersweet setback gave Thomas more time to dedicate to his loving wife, Kelly, their 4 children, and his charity, Defending Dreams.
2005, when I got to Charlotte, young kid, new city, didn't really know what to expect. Unlike some of the other guys that I've been around, I was fortunate enough to meet the girl that I would marry a few years later. I didn't know that we would end up at that point when I met her at the time, but we've been inseparable since. My wife, Kelly, we met August the 21st, 2005, and we've been inseparable since. We now have 4 kids together. She actually had a kid from a previous relationship. I had one from a previous relationship, and we ended up having 2 kids together. Now we have a beautiful family. She's definitely, oh man. She's definitely a person that I can rely on. Had a lot of hardships over my career the past few years, and without hesitation, man, she's been there for me. Tore my ACL now 3 times in a row within less than 2 years. And as a player, as a person, period, you know, that can get extremely stressful and can get hard on you. And if you allow it, then it can conquer you. But, you know, with my faith in God and, you know, with my wife backing me the whole way, taking care of me when I couldn't do it, getting the things that I needed done when I was laying in the bed, legs propped up, without any backlash, without any hesitation, babe, what do you need? She was always there for me, man, and I'm extremely thankful for her. And that's been another thing that's been very beneficial to my success and me being where I am today.